3, 2, 1. Hello, group. Jeff here. So, believe it or not, there's not a cloud in the sky, and I'm taking it. So, I have M1. I just looked outside. It looks dark enough. I still had some blue at the horizon. So, this is a 3-second exposure at a gain of 40. So I'm going to start making some adjustments here. I'll just show you my settings. Gain 40. 3-second exposure. Auto white balance. You can tell it's getting darker. It keeps changing. I have my color adjust. Everything is stock except for contrast and gamma. I have my frame rate on high. I'm in color, no flip. Rotation none, sampling none, region of interest none. I'm additive bin 2, and I have no dark, I have no flat, my black level is at 3, I have no stack going right now, and I'm at high contrast gain. Cooling is on, and I'm at minus 0.2, so I'm thinking I might want to raise the temperature just a tickle. We'll see where it goes. We'll just leave it. I don't have any sharpen, and everything else is stock. So I just did a quick align, basically dropped the scope on marks, and used my pointing model from that I made the last time I was able to get out in the new Celestron C PWI software. And so basically it took me 4 minutes to set up today. I took the mount, the weights, the scope, everything out on my redneck dolly, landed it out on the driveway on my marks, put my dampeners underneath, made sure I was still level, which I was, and for my align, I did a, I even forget what it's called, but it's a, it's where you can load your point model that you made the last time you were out. And then it will ask you to find a star and center it. And then you've got, you're good to go. And this was the first thing that I slewed to was M1. And it was a little higher and to the right, but it was in the field of view. So cool. I'll take it. And you can see that my white balance is shifting here. So, oops, wrong one. Let me just do another quickie. Yeah. Probably going to do that for the next 20 minutes till it gets dark. So I'm going to start a stack. And I'm going to push the black a little bit. There we go. I'm going to enable the stack. And because I'm at 3 seconds, this is going to build pretty quick. That's 100%. This is 200. Let's see what we can see here. Already at 7. 8. 7. And I'm in the garage, so I have my 15 meter active cable in the garage, and I've strung it out to the mount that's in the driveway. So I'm fairly warm. I'm not in the wind. And this is starting to form up nicely, and I haven't even done anything yet. So at 24 frames, I'm going to move the white. And I might even move the black a little bit. Zoom back out. Just want to make sure that my white balance is 25. Let's move the white to 150. And we'll move the black a little more. And I'll just do another quickie white balance just to stay ahead of the setting sun. So this is 200% and it is looking sweet. Got 40 frames in the stack. Go down to 140. Might push the black a little more. So this is basically my lazy man's live high dynamic range process. There's nothing overly complicated about it. I have my 8-inch Newt out in the driveway on a CGX mount that I aligned with StarSense about a week ago and created a point model. And I'm using that point model for my star align. And then I have the DS10 with a Orion Skyglow 1.25 filter stuck inside the camera. And I'm using the ZWO to 125 adapter to hold the filter. I've got 70 frames. I might move the white a little more. I don't want to go too far because I hate when it gets too white on me. So that's 400%. Not bad. I made a, with my 3D printer, I can print up to 10-inch Botnoff masks. And this is a Botnoff mask that I made for my Newt. So the focus on the stars is pretty good. And my just starting to see maybe a little drift. Not much. Looking for some black borders. This is looking pretty sweet. So I have 100 frames in the stack. That's 400% zoom. Not bad. 200, 100. So when we get to 100 and, let me do some math here. I think it's 120 is my magic number. Yep. Let's take a snap at 120. And then I'll do a live process on it. I'm not going to save that because I do all of my everything I do is for post-production, and it's just an old habit. Not that I want to do it, I just like to do it because I have so many cloudy days that it's nice to have something to do when there's clouds out. Oops, I went a little too far, so I'll go to 128. This is looking pretty good. And at 3 seconds a crack, who cares? Would be 36, right? Take a snap. Zoom in a little, 200%. And then I'll open up the process. And then bring the whites in. So that doesn't look too bad for no darks, no nothing. Picking up a little bit of a, must be, it is windy here, so go back and see what we got. I'm gonna save this frame. Today is 03. Actually, it's 2020-03-15, I think. Yeah. We'll make stills since. So this is M1 at gain 40, exposure 3, bin 2. Stack of 136. 8, and there's no sharpening, so I'll save this and then get rid of it. And we're at 198. Doesn't look too shabby. I'm going to snap this. Go to 220. Not bad for an 8-inch scope. And a 3-second exposure. I love it. See, my colors are drifting a little to the red. couple more frames and we're there. 19, 20. Snap. And we'll call this save as. And this is do 20. Save. See ya. We'll stop the stack and we'll go someplace else here. So we'll just hop over to Stellarium because I'm using Stellarium to kind of tell me where I'm at. Flaming Star. I haven't seen that in a long time. And there she be. So let's up the exposure. Probably going to have to go trigger mode here. We'll try 10 seconds. Yeah, there she be. Ooh, look at that. Let's go back to video. Stop. Okay, so this is very diffuse, it looks like. Let's see what we get here. So we'll go back to trigger mode. Take a look at the histogram. Oops, gotta start the damn thing. One, two, three. Pretty close, I think. These three stars. So let's just see what we can do here. So let's bring we'll stop this and make it 8 seconds. Let's see if that brings it in a little closer down here. That's better. So now I'll do a white adjust. And I'll go to right about there. Okay. This. So now I'm going to bring the black over to 40. I'll start the stack. Just do a quickie white balance again. And we'll enable the stack. And these are 8 second frames. I haven't changed the gain. And it looks like I've got a little bit of schmutz happening here. A reflection of some sort. Probably from one of my neighbors. Not sure where the scope is pointing. We'll let this stack build up a little bit. And I'm just going to go see where the scope is pointing. So this is the Flaming Star. Yeah. 14 input and 13 output. Starting to look pretty good. So here's 16 frames. So I'll start to move. Well, let's see what the noise looks like first. Maybe I'll go to 24. Okay, I'm at 24 right now. Getting some nice details in here. Cleaning up nice. I can tell you this much, there's more stars in this image than I would care to count. Holy crap. Just gonna do another quickie white balance because it's still moving on me. Probably could have gone up a little bit. Looks like there's some pretty cool stuff happening down here. That must be this. So I am backwards, I think. What are you gonna do? The old flaming star is coming out pretty good here, boys and girls. I have seen this before, and what fixed it was doing a reset. So what I'll do is I'll let this go to let's just say 60 frames, and then I'm going to do a reset. Nice clean image though. Live and learn. So 54 frames input, 54, actually 55, 54. I don't think I've ever seen this purple. If I didn't mention it, I will again. I have the Orion Skyglow filter in tonight, the 1.25, because I have to put my filter with the Newtonian. I have to actually put the filter inside the camera. Now, I got no vignetting either. That's pretty nice. I think that might be where this reflection is coming from. It might be bouncing off the filter. We'll see. Sixty frames coming up. That's where I'm going to snap, and I'll stop the stack. Well, I'll let it go. What the heck? Save as. This is what. We'll just call it the Flaming Star. Flaming Star Nebula. Tough to type with the darn gloves on. Damn it. And it was a stack of 60. I'll save it. I will do a quickie process. I definitely have to go down. So that's what I'm going to do. I'll kill this. I will go to video mode. Stop, Jeff. Is that stack still going? Yeah. Sorry. And we want to take this guy up, I think. Yes. Let's see what that does for us. Go too far, maybe. There. Okay, so we're going to go back to trigger mode and looper. I'll do a quickie white balance in here, maybe. Yeah, this might look a little better. I looking better. Let's go to... a little more white mauve here. Yeah, that'll work. Sure, we're good, and we are. So I'll start the stack. So again, it's 8 seconds. I seem to have lost my reflection. So I'm not quite sure what that might have been. Made a manual adjustment on the red, which helped. This time of day around here, I have so much pollution from the city, and I'm kind of shooting just off to the edge of the city, so I'm getting a little bit of the light dome, and it, between dusk, the light dome, it just, I have to play with the histogram all the time. This is gonna look good. I'm glad I moved it down. I'm getting all these goodies in here. And there is some purpley stuff in there, it looks like, which is kind of cool. Look at this, jeez, that's only in with 11 frames. and according to my phone, it is not quite dark yet. So it's, what time is it? It is 8 o'clock, so that's 20. I'm still in dusk. This is amazing. It doesn't get dark here until 9 o'clock. Amazing. Thanks for these cameras, Rock. And thanks, Jack, for selling them to me. Unbelievable. I wouldn't even try this with a DSLR at this time of day. Wouldn't even try it. So this computer is an MSI GS75 Stealth. It's a i7 9750H, I think. It's a 6-core, 12-thread machine. I'm doing an OBS 1920 by 1080 capture of this, and I've got Mallincam open. I've got CPWI open. I've got PhD open. I've got Stellarium open, and I'm making my movie. Unfreaking believable. This is really shaping up nice. So I've got 24 frames in the stack, and I'm going to move to 188 and see what we can see. I'll start moving in. That's 100%. Look at that stuff. And we got a little bit of trail going on here, but I think a lot of that's the wind. Sorry. Not much I can do about that. But the because I'm not really pushing the gain and the exposure's too awfully bad, my images are darker in visual. So what you see on the screen is the way I like it, because I don't like to blow anything out. And a good example is this star here isn't blown out, nor is this one. And when I start to move my white point, the star will never blow out. It just stays the way it is because I built up that big base of 24 frames before I do anything. And that clears out the noise. So if I zoom in, this noise isn't bad at all for this, what we're doing here. That's a sweet looking image. And then when I take this image into post, I can push the heck out of it because I haven't done anything to hurt the image. I'll have to remove, in this particular case, I'm just bouncing off mirrors. So I have the Newtonian. So there's an 8-inch mirror and then the secondary mirror, and it's going through two pieces of glass, the filter and the crystal for the camera. That's it. So this is my cleanest optical train of all the scopes that I own. The Raza's got the corrector, the mirror, then it's going through lots of glass before it even gets to the camera. And then if I throw a filter in, that's another piece of glass. My C14 is pretty much along the lines of the Raza, because if I run with my focal reducer, that's another piece of glass. And all of this glass has a coating, except for the crystal that's in the camera. And I don't believe, there might be a coating on the focal reducer, but I'm not sure. So every time you're sending your photons through a piece of glass, you're hurting it a little bit. Man, this is looking good. Wow. This is the best flaming star I've ever got. I don't think I've ever seen this colorization of this in here, up through here. This is pretty sweet. And I'm not really, you know, I'm just letting the stack build. I'm moved the white point once in the black point, maybe two clicks, and that's it. So I have 50 frames. We'll wait till it gets to 60. I'll take a snap, and then I'll show you. I'll save the, what is the flaming star? Is this the flaming star? Yes. So this is Flaming Star B. Oh, gorgeous. Using Mallincam Sky, I can do a little bit of post work just by playing with levels. And you can see, because I'm not pushing anything, I don't even push the white point, because I know I can stretch the image in post-production a lot farther than I ever would. And if I was doing visual, I would still do this, and then I would put up, I'd take a snap and then do a range on it and say, wow, look at that. nobody would know the difference. They would see a pretty picture. So I'm at 60 frames right now. So I'll snap it. I will save it. And Flaming Star B. Dash B. And this is 60. Okay, save. And what I'll do, and you'll notice I'm saving as TIFF file still. There's a reason for that. Oops. So we'll go into range. I'll move this up here. We'll crush the blacks. And now I'll push the whites. Oh yeah, that's sweet. That is the best Flaming Star I've ever gotten. Unbelievable. Gorgeous. Close this. And because I saved my snaps right away, there's no need for me to keep them because I don't do, I'm not showing this. There's nobody standing behind me looking at my images except me. Me, myself, and I. So maybe I'll just... That's still looking good. Go down to 180. And I'll let this go out to... frames do I want to go? 120. Ten times eight is 80. Is 96. So the illumination is coming up. I'm not really blowing anything out. And when I bring this image into Photoshop, it will, by the time I remove any gradients that are in this image, it's going to be sweet. My new word for today is sweet. So I'm at 82. I'm gonna go take a look and see where Orion is, if it's cleared the tree. Man, I can't believe how high Venus is. Oh my god, I wish it was warmer and I'd have the 14 out. It's 400% people. And I'm not guiding. And I've got just a little bit of a line starting to show up right here. And that's because I didn't polar align today. I'm just using my model that I created. If I had polar aligned and then used my model, I would have been golden. But because I didn't, I was in a hurry. It's been so long since I've been out. I want to see stars. This is pretty, 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 pretty. You know, I think what I might do might kill me. But I might double up. I might go to bin one and see what happens. I think I am looking at a light from someplace. What? I don't know. Pretty. Pretty stuff. So I'm at 106, 105. I'm going to take it out to 120, and then I'm going to go to bin one and see what we can find on how bad I have to. And I'm not using darks, people. If you notice, because I'm not using any darks, like right here. Oops. I don't know what this walking noise is. That. But every now and then, like here, that's schmutz here. Here. Darks probably would take that out. Here. Here, there, there, there. Still looks pretty good. Man. So I'm at 8 seconds, and I have. I'll have 120 frames. 8 times 120 divided by 60 is 16 minutes. Holy crap. Not bad for 16 minutes. Back in the old DSLR days, I would be spending all night to get something that wasn't even this good. Unbelievable. 120 frames. Beautiful. There must be some high clouds. Okay, so this is save as Flaming Star B. And this is 120. So what I will do is just do a quick process for you. Bring up the range. Crush the black. Bring up the whites. Not too shabby. Beautiful. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm going to load the factory preset. Let's see, did it change? Oh, I have to turn off some stuff first. Let me stop the stop. There we go. Yeah, that worked. So my conversion gain is high. My cooling is on. Sharpen off digital binning, white balance. Okay, so let's see what we can see here. Just white balance. Let's kill this. Oh, I know why. Jeez, dumbass. Duh. So we want to go up to, let's try 12 seconds and see what we get. We'll go to 40. As you can see, I'm very conservative on the gain. 12, let's loop, let's white balance, color adjust, make it 24. Okay, so I can live with this. Let's move this up to 15. Up to 16, let's go. See what we get. That's better. So let's take go to 18. So theoretically, I should have less noise. And you can see that I don't have this thing going on up here. Yeah, I like this better. Okay. So we'll go 12. We'll start to stack. Let's see what we can see. So I've doubled the pixel count. Less sensitive, but I've doubled the pixel count. The reason why I want to do this is to see what happens in this finer stuff. And I can tell already it's going to look better. So when you double the pixels, it always helps. So let me try one more thing. I'll stop the stack. And I'm going to sacrifice a little noise. Oops, stop. Oop, wrong way, Jeff. Just going to try doing... And then I'll bring the... See what happens. The little bit of noise that we get, I'm not going to be too awfully concerned about. Yes, much better. Much better. So let me do... Another white balance. Yeah. And we'll go up to 14 on the black and we'll start the sack. One of the things I've found is if you give yourself a lot of room, and you're not pushing the histogram too far to the right, when you do make your white point move, it's, even though you're moving it a lot, it's a gradual increase in luminance, which is more to my liking. Look at this. Oh yes, right in there. That's already looking better. Yep. So we'll see how long it takes to clear up the noise. Set. Damn. Hope it's not Starlink. I got Starlink the last time I was out. And just so you know, their launch aborted at T0 today. So there's 60 less Starlinks in the air. Only the Lord knows when they're going to go again. So I'm going to lose this set. Might have some high clouds coming through. The histogram is moving a little too much for my liking. It's not 9 o'clock yet, it's only 8:30, so it's still not officially dark. That might be it. I like this. So I got 3 frames in the stack, and what I'm going to do is, because I'm at 14 seconds, which is I was at 8, so I'm a little less than double. I'm 2 seconds less than doubling the exposure. And I went up 20 clicks on the gain. But I'm already liking what I'm seeing here. There's some really nice detail in there. Right in here, right here. I really wish, and it's a bandwidth thing. It has nothing to do with Rock's website. It's people's bandwidth, that there was a way that the when you're watching somebody's broadcast, there was a way that you could get what you see on your monitor. I mean, you really need some, you need a big pipe. And that costs money. And with what he has on the Night Sky Network, it's really a cool thing. I just wish it wasn't flash. The bane of my existence. This is gonna, you can see how much finer that looks. There's a lot more detail just by doubling up on the pixels. I'm a pixel guy. The first time I got an image out of my Canon 5D Mark II, which was 24 megapixel, I almost fell on the ground. Going to Rock's cameras, I've lost resolution, but I've gained so much more in the fact that I can go and I can image so many more targets in a night. And I like to play. So like as an example, this Flaming Star, I can see stuff in the Flaming Star, so now I'm trying some things to see if I can do better. I don't necessarily have to hop all over the sky. This is a fairly high object. It's setting, so it's on the west for me. And when I first got on this target, it was fairly high. So this is a perfect target for me. And because I have trees, I'm kind of tree locked. I only have the west to look out of, a little hole to the east, nothing to the north, and I'm limited to the south. So I'm kind of, you know, when I get on a target, I like what it looks like, I'll stay on it until I get it the way I like it. Yeah, this is gonna be nice. So I'm going at 16 frames. Mean, there's still a lot of noise in here, but more than I would go. I can wait till 24. Let me go to 24. You can see I'm trailing a little bit. That's the wind. If I can get my guider working. Oh, you know what? I bet you I got the freaking cap on the thing. I do. I wonder it ain't working. Stop. I'll be right back. Thank you. That's what it was. Start over. Sorry. You know what? Let me try one more thing here. As long as we're on, I'm guiding now. So I'll stop, I'll go up to 80, which is 50% of the, gain. I'll bring this down a couple clicks. Let's try 10. Well, let's see what happens. I was at what, 40, 60, 80. So let's try 10. Let's see where we're at. Yeah, that's gonna work. Okay. Let me start the stack. So I've upped the gain and dropped the exposure. So we will see how fast the noise clears out. This is the best night I've had since October of last year. Unbelievable. So my stars should be round now. Let's see how much room. Not filling anything up yet. So I've got 4 frames and we've probably lost half the noise. I'm at 75%. Let's go up to 100. And it's still pretty noisy. Ten, eight. And right here, you see that right there? In here? That's because I don't have a dark here. Hot pixels. Here. Here. But that's okay. I'm just trying some stuff. And you can also tell that because I'm guiding this, that's helping. But because I've doubled the pixel count, my stars are rounder. So when I zoom in on them, I'm at, I'm not getting that funky square star look. Wow, there's some nice stuff going on here. Okay, so that's 16 frames. Still a little noisy. I'm going to let it go up to 24. And then I'll start moving the white point. The other thing that I've found is that the smaller you can make your white balance box, the better you are, because you're really trying to find black for that white balance. And when you've got a lot of diffuse nebulosity like this, it's tough to find black. So if you make your box small, you can always zoom in like this. Oops. Make your box a little smaller and then make sure that there's no stars underneath your box. And then when you select black, you know that you're golden. Okay, almost there. So I'm going to start to move my white point. And I'm going to go to 180. So my guiding, if I'm reading this right, is 0.4. Not bad. Not bad for a CGX. Although the fish scale I bought really helped me on the balance, because the CGX is stiff, it doesn't free roll. So both in RA and DEC, it's just a little bit stiff, and I'm not sure if that's the grease they use or the bearings. I understand that they have a steel and a Teflon bearing. So it'd be steel, Teflon. And that is probably why it's a little stiffer. So what I use is a digital fist scale, and I'll just pull on the end of the weight bar, or the counterweight bar where the hook is, and I just make sure that it's equal, and then I'll move a weight so that I'm east heavy. And on the for the right RA, I make sure not RA, but DEC, I make sure that I'm a little tail heavy, because you're always looking up. So I'd rather be a little tail heavy than nose heavy on the mount. So I'm gonna just crush the blacks some more. at 40 frames. See, the noise is clearing out nice. That's 300%. Looking good. I probably could have gone with a little more exposure, but we'll take this. My spikes are looking better now with the guide. Yeah, the RA is you can tell I'm a little bit off on my polar line. Not too bad. 0.52. I'll take anything under one. Yeah, this is really something. This is looking white, so let's go up on the black. I have to wonder if there's clouds. I think some of my black would be my darks. I don't have darks. It's hurting me a little bit, but that's okay. Like they say, you fix it in post, baby. Check the noise. It's not bad. You know, I could be doing up. I don't have any heaters on the Newt. After this is done, I'll have to take a quickie run out there. See what I got. Thank you. 76. It's 80. We'll go to 80. And then we'll go someplace else. So, interesting test here. Just missed a set going through. Couple more frames. This is the Flaming Star B, so we'll call this C. Bin 1. Gain 80. 10 second exposure. And the stack is, what was the stack? And just bring up the adjust, just to see what we can see here. Stop at stack. Go back to the faults. Stop. Go back to bin two. We'll make the gain 40 again. And we'll try stop this. And we'll zoom out. Let's try M1. Get M1 before it's too late, so let's go into trigger mode. Let's make it 50. Let's go 60, see what happens. Looper. I can work with this. Okay, close that. See if we line them up. We do. A hot pixel, so I might have to turn this down. Yeah, let me stop. Too many hot pixels. Stop. 140. And we'll go up to 8, see what happens. We like this. Let's stack. Should clear out pretty quick. To clear, see what we get. Four, I'll move it. And this is looking sweet. Oh, look at that. Shit. Excuse my French. Be right back. Tell you what, these gloves. I got some pop-top gloves. These things are sweet. It's 200%. Nice. Okay, I'm going to make my move. And I'm at 1.44. I can take that. Not a bad image for an 8-inch Newtonian. Got 44 frames in the stack. I think the topaz denoise is going to do something nice to this guy. That's 300%. Man. It's 100%. I think this is the best crab I've ever gotten. It's always, by the time I get the 14 out, it's a little too low for me, and it's in the mud in the west. So I get some Skyglow and a lot of atmosphere to go through by the time I get the 14 out. This is looking nice. I mean, just the stuff that's right in here. Got the little filament things coming off. I don't think I've ever seen that. Never seen this. 14 would really pull that out. Plus, I'd be in tighter on it, so it'd be bigger. Go to 120 frames. And hope the helicopter doesn't fly through. And if you notice, I'll just move the black a couple clicks just so that the white, as the white starts building in, it doesn't overpower the black. And it seems to help on long stacks. A 6 second exposure is getting this. Unbelievable. With an 8-inch Newtonian. Way to go, Rock. Getting all kinds of little goodies down and through here. The post ought to pull a lot of this out. And I got 100 pixels. It's 100% right there. So if we go to Stellarium, that's about right. So this is my field of view. Just back out a little bit so you can see. So it is very close, if not spot on. I guess I entered the right numbers. I'm guiding 1.39. Unbelievable. Nice. Great guiding. Wind must have died down. I like to guide. I don't need to guide as much with the Raza because the Raza is so short. The Newtonian is, it actually weighs 20 pounds and it's about 4 feet, maybe. Who knows? Three and a half feet. So it's got a pretty good moment arm on it. At 96, 24 more frames, and we'll call this one. And I'll try. Something, maybe the running man. I haven't done the running man in a while. That is really something for an 8-inch scope. Percent. I don't think I've ever seen this stuff right in here. Jeez. Nice. 104. And if you notice, I don't do a lot of work to get these images. And I'm still exposing for post. I'm not doing it for visual, and I'm getting some great visual shots here. Nothing in this is blown out. And we got some really cool stuff going on in there. I wonder if that's the star that made all this. Wouldn't that be something? Okay, we've got seven more frames and we can take a snap. Beautiful. So I'll save it. M1 gain 40, 120. This we'll call this M1B because it's darker. Bin 2, save. And then we'll go in and just do a quickie range for you. Something else. Gorgeous. I don't think I've ever gotten that much of the red. Pretty cool. So I'm going to stop my movie.